Subscribe and press bell icon to never miss update from Smokey Play.
So guys, as we all know that in episode 110, Goku's new transformation was shown, but does it really look like the one revealed in the official posters? No, it doesn't. The official posters showed the blue and red aura surrounding Goku, which we didn't get to see in episode 110. Now the question is, the transformation appeared in the poster, is it the final transformation of Goku? Can this limit breaker form be more powerful than Ultra Instinct? So in today's video, I'll be explaining in detail about both these forms of Goku and what is the ultra power of Goku and how he can attempt it. So let's begin. First, I'll be talking about Goku's transformation in episode 110 and his ultra power. So as already been told several times that Goku's ultra power is not a form, guys. Ultra power is a technique just like Kaioken. Kaioken increase the body speed, strength and fighting skills. On the other hand, ultra power frees up the body parts and help in attacking the opposite opponent by defending and countering the attack at the same time. Wow, right? So the one who acquires it doesn't really have to do anything. This technique kinda let your body do self-movement, which means you can attack several times at one go. Now talking about if Goku can attempt ultra power once again. If tried, he can, as ultra power is a type of technique just like Kaioken. So once fully charged, Goku can try to attempt it and can even succeed in achieving it. Now let's get back to the transformation. As the poster showed the blue and red aura around Goku, which seems like a combination of Super Saiyan blue and Super Saiyan red. If that's what you think it is, then it's not. It's not a combination of Super Saiyan blue and Super Saiyan red, guys. What I think what can be the case here is Goku might have combined his ultra power with Kaioken, which resulted in blue and red aura around him. Because the heat of the ultra power is blue and the aura of Kaioken is red, so when combined together produced blue reddish aura around him. Well, that's what I think might have been the case here. Now the other question which is probably coming to your mind right now is, what could have forced him to combine both the techniques? Okay, now listen up. In episode 110, while fighting, Goku wasn't in his full power, nor Jiren was. But despite of Goku being in his ultra power, Jiren was able to defend his every attack. So we can say that Jiren has already achieved ultra power, which means both Goku and Jiren have the same level of power or skills, which make them defend each other's attack and no one loses to the other. And the fight goes on and on. So if Goku wants to win, then he has to take the risk of combining his ultra power with Kaioken, which means going beyond Ultra Instinct form to beat Jiren. So guys, what you think about my theory of Goku's transformation? Is his new form a combination of ultra power and Kaioken? If yes, hit the like button. And how you think he'll be achieving it? Do comment your views and theories about this in the comments section down below. And don't forget to subscribe our channel for more videos. Thank you.